Welcome everybody. Today I will explain what is snubber circuit and its applications. Here you see only 3 figures. I have total 16. Remaining are in other sheets. When we connect one resistor and one capacitor in series, and this RC is connected in parallel of thyristor, then this RC is called snubber circuit. Sometimes the snubber circuit is used to protect not only thyristor but diode, transistor, triac, and sometimes even switch. Now we will know what are its applications. First application in helping in latching current development. When we trigger the thyristor, a current will start flowing in this when thyristor becomes on. And this wire will have some inductive load or wire inductance or transformer inductance. So current in thyristor will increase slowly. It will take some time to reach latching current. For example, for thyristor TYN612, latching current is 60 milliampere. So this is IL, this is 60. So thyristor current is increasing like this. It will take this much time from here to here to cross this 60 milliampere. So gate pulse should be longer than this. I have shown longer gate pulse. Otherwise, thyristor becomes off and it will not latch. Now, how RC helps? When this thyristor becomes on, this capacitor will discharge through this resistor like this. This I2 current is shown here. This is RC current. This current, I1, was this green color current. In thyristor, this current plus this current both will flow. So this I1 green color plus I2 blue color, this I3 will be red color like this. Here you see I3 current in thyristor has crossed IL immediately. So you can give shorter gate pulse. So it helps to reduce the gate pulse width. But when this current flows, this current rises very fast. So helping in latching current, it helps in bigger size thyristors. In smaller size thyristor, this may be problem. Third is voltage sharing. Suppose we have two thyristors in series and both are off. Here also I have seen anti-parallel. These also are off. When thyristors are off, they will have some resistance. These resistors are shown here. Suppose we give 500 volt and these two resistors are 50k, 50k. Then these resistors are equal, the equal voltage will come, 250 volt here, 250 volt here. If these resistors are not equal, say this resistance is 10 kilo ohm and this resistance is 90 kilo ohm, then voltage sharing will not be equal. Here you will get only 50 volt, here you will get 450 volt. In case of thyristor, leakage impedance are not equal, thyristor to thyristor. It's not like this. They have lot of variation. Because of variation, voltage given here does not divide here and here equally. If you give 500, 250 and 250 will not come. One may have more, one may have less. So thyristor may fail. Whichever has more voltage, that thyristor may fail. voltage sharing, we connect RC. This RC impedance and this RC impedance are equal. And this RC, ZRC value is much less than impedance of this. So this decides the sharing, not this. And when they are equal, like this, you will get 250 here, 250 here. But this snubber circuit will help in voltage sharing if you give AC voltage input. If you give DC voltage, it does not help in improving voltage sharing. In that case, one resistor is connected in parallel of this. This is not snubber circuit. I am just telling that we connect one resistor here and here. This decides the voltage sharing, not this. This helps only during AC input. Now we will discuss dB by dt protection. This I have shown one AC wave. Say this is 200 volt. In this AC wave, the surge is coming. Generally, surge will come with high voltage and will superimpose on this. So AC wave will become like this. And here I have shown if thyristor was on and has become off. So you see dV by dt means V by T. Here this is V, this is T, this is very low. Here V is little more, so V by T is high. Here V is very high, T is less. This T may be order of few 10 microseconds, sometime even few microseconds. So V by T is very high. Here also V by T is very high. So here and here dV by dt is very high in this AC. Here dV by dt is low, here it is low, here somewhere in between. Now we will see how snubber circuit helps. Generally impedance of this C at 50 Hz at line frequency is higher than this. So this impedance is higher. But when the high frequency component comes, at higher frequency, this impedance is 1 by C omega. When omega is more, this will reduce. If F is high, Z low. And this value becomes even lower than this. So this value becomes very low. Here I have seen the input. The green color is this. When we connect the RC, because this impedance becomes low, this green will become like this. This is with thyristor, voltage across with thyristor with RC. This is voltage across thyristor without RC. So this attenuation is taking place. This we will discuss here in detail. Suppose this resistor value is 100 ohm. I have shown 100 ohm. One C is connected and there is a thyristor. And thyristor is half. Now when frequency is very high, the resistance or impedance of this capacitor becomes low, very low, very low even compared to this. So this RC behaves like only resistor because this impedance is much lower than this at very high frequency. So this RC at high frequency equivalent I have shown here. So this 100 ohm is shown here, C is not shown because C has very low value now. Now if we apply 1 kV, full 1 kV will come here. We have no protection. Okay. Now here what happens? Suppose here in series we have 100 ohm resistor. This circuit is this. When you apply high frequency 1 kV surge, voltage will divide and we get only 500 volt. So dV by dt is reducing. Here it was not reducing, it is reducing. Some advantage is there. Here, suppose in place of G there is a reactor. Reactor has impedance L omega. So when frequency is high, this omega is high, so this impedance will be very high. So this value L omega will become much higher than this R, because higher frequency, this impedance becomes low, but this becomes high. So this impedance will be very high, this will be very low. So this voltage will be sharing in between this and this. So you get low voltage here because low resistance, you will get high voltage here because high impedance. So along with L, dy by dt reduces drastically. Now from where inductance will come? Only our circuit will have some kind of primary transformer, there will be wire. This wire also will be having inductor. So this inductor will play a role here. But in higher power circuits or industrial circuits, we don't depend upon this because we don't know the value of L here. So we connect a reactor in series of this, like this. This is air core reactor such that it does not saturate. In this reactor, full current will flow. So this reactor is this. Whenever surge comes, drop will come here and this voltage or thyristor is protected. This current will flow. When thyristor is on, when thyristor is off, current will not flow. But during surges, all drop will be here. This reactor behaves like di by dt protection also. Because in reactor, current doesn't increase immediately. It behaves like inertia for the current. So this reactor limits the di by dt also. Now we will talk about polarization of a circuit. There are two types, forward and reverse. This is forward type Snubber circuit. Here one diode is connected and value of R1 is much lower than R2. This is lower than this. So when the high frequency surge comes here, current will flow like this because this resistance is of lower value. In reverse, current cannot flow like this, current flow through R2. In such circuit, only one diode is connected in parallel of thyristor. This kind of circuit is also used to protect transistor switching. Suppose this point is this. When transistor becomes off, surge will come and it will reduce. When it becomes on, current will flow through this resistor, not through this. This is reverse. This similar circuit. But here, anode was here, cathode here it is reverse. When surge comes here, this C and this R will form Snubber circuit. This is used to discharge this capacitor. Then there are some other kind of Snubber. Snubber means to attenuate something. This is flyback diode type Snubber. When transistor becomes on, current will flow. When it becomes off, current will not reduce to zero because reactor doesn't allow current to become zero immediately. So this current will flow like this. If it is not there, this current will tend to flow through this capacitor, stray capacitor, and more voltage will come here. So this current will continue to flow till due to losses it becomes zero. Losses will be here also. Then varistor, Zener diode, transistor also act like attenuator for over voltage. Then there are mechanical snubbers. Car belt is best example, which protect us from transient movement. When body has sudden movement, That time car valve will come in the picture. It will not allow our body to move forward. Thyristor was proposed by William Shockley in 1950 and then developed by a team led by Goldenhall in 1956. Today, this much only.